This one we're not going to do just because it does take some time, but I did want to kind of explain it. This is called the lava lake. And how it works, and there's a million different variations on this one, but you start with these three pads, and you tell your group that my favorite story is, okay, so we're on an island, we came here as a group to explore and, you know, find some things, and suddenly the volcano erupts, and there's this lake of lava between us and our plane home, and we've got to get across the lake. Now, fortunately, we thought ahead, and we brought our lava-proof mats. We've got three of them, but there's, you know, eight people in our group. We've got to get all of us from here to there. And you're going to set up a length of space, and again, you have to know your group and figure out what's going to be a challenge for them, but doable in the time that I have, and not such a challenge that it's just going to overwhelm them and they're going to give up. So set up a length of space that kind of fits that criteria, okay? You can only step on the special pads. Now the other thing you can do to, depending on the skill level of your group, is create a time limit. And that volcano is going to erupt in 15 minutes. So we've got to get from here to there in that 15 minutes, okay? Or we're all goners. And you can also set up injuries, okay? So you know, for example, that Susan always tells everybody, okay, this is what we're going to do, and this is how we're going to do it, and she's going to take over the activity. You say, well, when the volcano erupted, Susan was so shocked, she's never seen such a thing before, that she was just rendered mute, and she cannot speak for the duration of this activity, okay? Or sometimes with kids who tend to be the big, tough guy and never wants to, you know, lean on anyone for anything, I'll tell them, you know, when it came, you didn't get out of the way fast enough, one of your legs got burned right off, so now you've only got one leg. So now he needs some help to get across. And you set up those things, first of all, to make more of a challenge for the whole group, but also to kind of manipulate dynamics a little bit and see if you can get some of those quieter kids to step forward, or a kid who just needs to know how to lean on people, to give them that forced opportunity that they're going to have to lean on someone. And then you give them your three mats and you say, go. And that's all the direction you give. And again, in this one, I really do just sit back, and if they ask me questions, like, it varies. What do you think? and go back to those wilderness excursion days. And it takes them a while, but eventually they figure out that what you have to do is put down the mats and kind of create a little path here, and then pick them up. And if you're doing that, you can get two people ferried across from one side to the other, and then somebody's got to come back and get the rest of the group. If they don't figure that on their own, you may want to kind of demonstrate just a little bit to show them what they're doing. The first thing they do, especially ADHD kids, they get those three mats, they're like, okay, and I start across and I get here and I don't know what I'm doing now. Or one person, I know what I'm doing. And he gets across the other side, now he's got all three mats on the other side, and the rest of you guys are stuck on the shore by yourself. They'll try throwing the mats, and so you want to make sure that the distance you give them is too far to throw the mats, because that's one thing that they will try to do, is whip them back to everybody else, and you want to make sure that it falls short of the mark. A lot of times what I'll do is, if they get to a point and they're kind of reached an untenable point, they can't go on, we'll freeze it, we'll start over, I'll debrief a little bit right in the middle. So what do you think went well there? Where did we go wrong? What might we do differently this time? And kind of talk about that. Now, how did you feel when you were stuck over here and he had all the mats over there and he was in safety and we were all trapped? And talk about those things. Okay, let's start over. Go again. And again, step back, let them try again, see if they get a little further this time. You can do this, I mean, you can set up any scenario you want, depending on your situation or your kids. Older kids may not go for the lake of lava. They may need something a little more exciting, cutting edge, I don't know. But anyway, any situation you want. And again, just manipulate, tailor it to your group and to the needs of your group.